Hey everyone, I'm Wes from The Gear Set, and today we are talking about the brand new 2020 Toyota Supra, so stick around. Before I even saw the Supra in person, I already had a preconceived notion that I wouldn't like it. It wasn't based off of looks at all. I didn't like the fact that, well, it's pretty much the same thing you guys don't like. It's BMW. Toyota did do a collaboration with BMW to do this car, and for good reason. BMW has been the king of inline six turbocharged engines for a very long time, ever since the Mark IV Supra left the market. And when Toyota decided to produce another Supra, there's no way that they could have swayed from that heritage of having an inline six turbocharged engine. So the most logical thing to do is to enlist the help of a company who's been known to produce some of the best inline six turbocharged engines in the world. Now, with that being said, there is a lot more BMW influence in the car than I would like to see. But again, we'll get into that later on. Initial impressions. When I first got my hands on the car, it was actually the second one I've seen on the road. Now, we are in Alabama right now, the bottom of Alabama. It's not Birmingham or anything fancy like that. It's a very small town, really quiet town of Enterprise, Alabama. There isn't a huge car scene in Alabama, in this part of the state anyway. So I didn't expect to see many Supras on the road down here. But the one that I did see was a week prior to me getting this one. So when I saw it, I immediately got super excited.
So excited! So excited!
My initial impression when I first got my hands on the car was that it looks way better than it does on the internet. The pictures that you guys see do it no justice whatsoever. It is a very sharp car. It's a little bit bigger than I thought it was going to be. It does have some space limitations. It is not difficult to get into, but you will find yourself having to learn how to get in and out of the car efficiently without constantly rubbing your belt or rubbing your foot on the door sill or something to that effect. If you look inside the car right now, there's tons of scuff marks from my shoe getting in and out, scuff marks on the seat for me sliding in and out. But once you get a hang of getting in and out of the car, it's just like any other car, just a little bit smaller. I think that the biggest thing that was influenced on this car from the Mark IV version of the Supra was the headlights. The headlights are very reminiscent of the Mark IV Supra. Toyota took it one step further and injected their own flavor of headlights that brings this Supra design current to this generation. The running lights, the LED projector headlights, the auto leveling technology that's built into it is all current technology. Down the side, definitely the general shape of the previous version of the Supra, although it does have a little bit of Toyota 86 influence in it. Tail lights, completely different. Everything on the butt is totally different, completely new, and I love the design of the rear end. The fact that the Supra doesn't have a real wing isn't disappointing at all. It's kind of weird to try to mold a wing into that rear trunk lid. There are some aftermarket ones that are available now. Everyone has been modified this car. They've done body kits, they've lowered it. On the interior is where I feel most of the BMW influence comes from. The gear selector is definitely BMW inspired. It's actually not BMW inspired, it's from BMW, period. The chimes when you start the car, 100% BMW. I'm not mad about it. It's just some chimes. Make sure you put your seatbelt on, they'll go away. The infotainment system that comes in the new Supra isn't the most user-friendly one out there on the market. I think that Toyota could have done a little bit better of a job getting to that user-friendly state. During the time that I had the vehicle, it did get easier to use, but if you are one of those people who just want to get in car and immediately start picking up things and, you know, just immediately knowing where to go for certain things in your infotainment system, you may struggle with this one just a little bit. It looks great. I love the design of the infotainment system. The layout, the colors, everything is really sharp. When you put it in reverse, the backup camera is really crisp. It's modern looking. It's very unique. And I think they did a really nice job in that aspect. The car sounds really, really good when you have it in sport mode. It pops, it burps when it shifts at high RPMs. I mean, it sounds really good, but Toyota and BMW both know that not everyone wants to sound aggressive all the time. So if you are out of sport mode, then it sounds just as tame as anything else that you can imagine. On the performance side of the house, the car is actually really quick. I can't stress that enough. It doesn't matter if you can't stand BMW or if you hate Toyota to death because they use a BMW engine in it. There's nothing that you can say that will make this car any less fast than it is. It is a very quick car. Launch control works great. This thing is a blast to drive. It is one of my favorite cars I've driven. I've had so much fun in this car, and I couldn't even take it to a track. We took it to a track, but I wasn't able to really drive it on the track, and even that was just an oval track anyway. The car is an absolute blast to drive on the street. It's super easy to drive, very controllable. Our test rig was $56,220. And for that price, you get the Supra in its stock trim, of course, which is 335 horsepower, 365 pound-feet of torque, an 8-speed automatic transmission with paddle shift. And it also has the sport rear differential as well. The brakes are Brembo, 4-piston, disc brakes, of course, and carbon fiber trim all throughout. Ours came with the black leather interior, which I'm actually glad it did. I think it would look weird with that red interior, with the red exterior. The wheels are 19-inch with Michelin Pilot Sport tires. And it also comes with a 12-speaker JBL audio system that sounds pretty daggone good. One other quirk on the 2020 Supra that I want to tell you guys about is not one that you will find on paper. Every now and then, I like to roll with the windows down. So I'll roll the windows down all the way. If you've been in a vehicle, a sedan, and you had the back windows rolled down and not the front, and you get that helicopter noise that's like blah, 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 and it's very annoying and it's almost like deafening, it does that. If you roll the front windows down, anywhere from about 45 to I say about 60 miles an hour, it's a very deafening aerodynamic sound that comes from having the windows down. Very easily avoidable, I guess, if you just roll the windows up and turn the AC or the heat on, but it is a noise nonetheless. Now, if you're one of those people who I just have to have my windows down, you're either gonna have to drive really, really slow or get a speeding ticket. I don't really know what to tell you. Because if you're in that range, you're gonna have that noise. You may be able to deal with it, but it's just something to note. And of course, this 2020 Toyota Supra, since it is a Toyota, it's gonna come with the Toyota Safety Suite as well. One of the coolest features that I think that BMW brought over to this car, aside from the engine and probably the transmission and the suspension and you know what, we're not even gonna talk about the rest of the stuff, but one of my favorite features that they actually brought over was the air circulation mode. You know how sometimes you drive down a road and you may come across a cow patch or something like that and it smells real bad and you have the AC on and you can just turn the air recirculation on to contain the air inside the vehicle instead of letting that fresh air come in? Well, BMWs have a system where it does it automatically. They brought that system to the Supra. So if you just have it in that auto mode and if it detects something that is less than pleasant, then it will actually shut those fresh air vents and only recirculate the air that's already in the car. Now, if you are excessively flatulent from eating maybe at your favorite taco place, that's a chain across the nation whose name I won't name, then it won't do anything to protect you from that smell. You're just stuck in the car with it. But you can't roll the windows down as long as you're over 60 or below 45. The seats have just about more adjustability than anything I've ever been in. They're quite comfortable. One thing that I wish though, I wish that I could slide the seat all the way back and recline it a little bit more than what it actually does. Because of the bracing and the structural parts of the car behind the seat, you actually can't recline the seat back far enough for me to be super comfortable. Now, the car is very much so drivable in the position that I drive in. It is comfortable, but sometimes I like to just recline. I got a bad back, so sometimes I like to recline just a little bit more in order to give myself a little bit of extra comfort. But that's gonna wrap up my review of the 2020 Supra. So glad we finally got our hands on this thing, and I hope you guys enjoyed the review as well. If you have any questions, just comment below or go ahead and email me at the email address that's, it should be right there. I think it's right there. I don't think it's gonna be up there, but it should be down there for sure. Hit me up on that email address right there. Make sure you follow us on Facebook. We have an Instagram, YouTube, the whole nine yards. And also, if you have any vehicle suggestions or gear suggestions, just go ahead and email us. We're gonna be doing a lot more stuff other than just cars in the near future. So we have some truck equipment coming up. We maybe have some tools coming up and even some aviation stuff. But we're not gonna talk about that. We don't talk. Why not? They know, but they should know already. They told me I can't talk about the aviation stuff. But okay, all right, I won't talk about the aviation stuff. All right, fine. All right. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you guys next time.